Welcome back, you delightful band of screen lovers. Today, we are tackling something that sounds fancy, but is really just another day at the animation office, animation retargeting. In case you're new here, that's where we take animations from one character and slap them onto another. Like trying to fit someone into someone else's shoes, only this time, the shoes fit perfectly, most of the time. We've got our source character, loaded up with all the animations, lounging in the source folder. Then we've got our target character in the target folder, which is basically a rigged mannequin that currently moves about as much as a statue. To start this process, we need to go to our source character and re-import it as an animation library. You know you've done it right when the icon changes. That's our cue to double-click on the animation library and head straight to the skeleton 3D node. Once there, find the retarget option, because that's literally what we are here for. Select new bone map, because we are imperative like that, and under profile, choose new skeleton profile humanoid. Then hit the re-import button. Feel free to whisper, "Do my bidding." As you do, it won't help, but it feels right. Now, we shift our gaze to the target character. Double-click it, navigate to skeleton 3D, select retarget, pick new bone map, and choose new skeleton profile humanoid again. Hit re-import. By now, you're probably getting good at this. To see if our target character can now strut its stuff, we'll create a new scene. I'll add a node 3D and give it a catchy name like test level. Drag the target character into this scene and make it local. This is where the magic happens, or where we realize we need to read the documentation again. Add an animation player node as the child of the character model. Head over to the animation tab, go to the manage animations, and find our trusted animation library from the source character. Click open, and if everything went according to plan, all those fancy animations are now running on our target character. Congratulations, you've made one character's moves into another character's moves. It's like you're a choreographer, but for 3D models. All that's left is to sit back, sip your coffee, and pretend this wasn't just another day of following the documentation. If you found this tutorial as useful as a good cup of coffee on a Monday morning, don't forget to hit the like button. Subscribe for more no-nonsense Godot tips, and drop a comment below if you've got any burning questions or just want to say hi. You know, because algorithms love engagement. Until next time, keep those pixels moving, those rings grooving, and remember, keep the code flowing and the passion glowing. Power hack out!